Good morning, students. Welcome to your English class. I'm your teacher, Jarna Pujari. I'm working in IIPM School of Engineering and Technology. So, yesterday we have discussed about what communication is, the root word communication, which comes from the words communicare. You can see our recent video, and that has been uploaded in the website, in this, and also in this YouTube channel. Okay, so today we would discuss what communication and types of communication. In a broad categories, communication can be divided into two parts. One is the verbal communication, another is the non-verbal communication. So what is verbal communication and what is non-verbal communication? So verbal communication is communication with words. Communication with words is known as verbal communication. What we are right now doing, interaction with you people, is verbal communication, because I am using some words to interact with you people. So it is verbal communication. We are verbally interacting with each other, right? So communication which uses words in the form of written or spoken is known as verbal communication. Move on to non-verbal communication. What is non-verbal communication? Communication without words. कम्युनिकेशन जो कि कोई भी वर्ड्स यूज नहीं करता है उसको बोला जाता है नॉन वर्बल कम्युनिकेशन. कम्युनिकेशन विदाउट वर्ड्स विच यूजेस सम साइंस एंड सिंबल्स. वी कैन इंटरेक्ट विद पीपल थ्रू सम पिक्चर्स. पिक्चर्स सेज मैनी थिंग्स, राइट? सो इट इज नॉन वर्बल कम्युनिकेशन. अगेन कम टू वर्बल कम्युनिकेशन. इन वर्बल कम्युनिकेशन, because the direct interaction between the sender and receiver is happens, the chances of confusion is few. There is fewer chances of confusion as direct interaction between the sender and receiver happens in verbal communication. What in non-verbal communication? Chances of misunderstanding is high, as use of language is not there in non-verbal communication. So chances of misunderstanding is high in non-verbal communication because there is no use of language. People interact with each other in sign languages, right? The physically challenged person who are visually impaired or listening impaired, they interact with the sign language, right? They interact with their own language, their sign language, and there the chances of misunderstanding sometimes happens, right? So this chances of misunderstanding is high in non-verbal communication. Okay, presence of sender and receiver is not necessary. In verbal communication, you can interact through cell phones, you can interact through a letter, you can send a letter to your friend, you can send an email to your boss while you are working in some field, okay, and you can interact. So the presence of sender is not that much necessary in वर्बल कम्युनिकेशन. यहाँ पर जो सेंडर एंड रिसीवर होते हैं उनका डायरेक्ट इंटरेक्शन, मतलब उनका प्रेजेंस उतना ज़्यादा नेसेसरी नहीं होता है. ओके, देन डायरेक्ट इन्वॉल्वमेंट ऑफ सेंडर एंड रिसीवर इज रिक्वायर्ड. इन नॉन वर्बल कम्युनिकेशन द डायरेक्ट इंटरेक्शन बिटवीन द सेंडर एंड रिसीवर इज रिक्वायर्ड. क्यों चाहिए? क्यों चाहिए? क्योंकि यहाँ पर साइन और सिम्बल्स यूज होता है ज़्यादातर, तो जो रिसीवर और सेंडर है वो डायरेक्ट इंटरेक्ट करना पड़ता है उन लोगों को. दैट्स व्हाई डायरेक्ट इन्वॉल्वमेंट ऑफ सेंडर एंड रिसीवर इज रिक्वायर्ड इन नॉन वर्बल कम्युनिकेशन. यस, सो फीडबैक इज वेरी फास्ट इन वर्बल कम्युनिकेशन. द फीडबैक जो आता है फ्रॉम द सेंडर, फ्रॉम द रिसीवर, व्हाइल सेंडर सेंड्स अ मैसेज, रिसीवर गिव्स द फीडबैक. फीडबैक इज वेरी फास्ट. ओके, ड्यू टू द फास्ट इंटरचेंज ऑफ information, feedback is fast in verbal communication, and comparatively in non-verbal communication feedback is slow because we interact with some signs and symbols, some pictures, it takes time to understand, and the feedback is slow in non-verbal communication. Okay, and in verbal communication the documentary evidence, जो documentary evidence है वो maintained होता है. documentary evidence is maintained in verbal communication. we can keep for record in our future use. future के काम में ये आ सकता है because we can keep a record, we can keep in written documentation, we can keep videography, okay, and verbal communication, the documentary evidence is maintained. Non-verbal communication में no conclusive evidence, उतना ज़्यादा conclusive evidence maintain नहीं किया जाता. So that is the basic difference between verbal and non-verbal communication. Once again we would discuss that communication with word is verbal communication, communication without word is non-verbal communication. Verbal communication का example है all the written and spoken communication, non-verbal का sign and symbols. Okay. Fewer chances of confusion in verbal communication, more chances of confusion in non-verbal communication. Presence of sender and receiver is necessary in verbal communication, direct involvement of sender and receiver is required in non-verbal communication. Ear feedback is very fast, ear feedback is very slow. Okay, then documentary evidence is maintained in verbal communication, no conclusive evidence is maintained in non-verbal communication. Okay, enough for today's class. We will meet again in next class. Thank you.